electronically challenged, but how many of you have seen them before, heard them before? Oh, there's a whole lot of people, and this is your first time, so you will be so enchanted. And I'm just going to read you a quote from some newspaper. It says, Emma's Revolution, they are smart, funny, and informative, like Rachel Maddow and Jon Stewart with guitars. Let's hear Emma's Revolution.
Same reason a lot of people join, you know. In his case, it was to get him out of poverty in the South. So, you know, it's our job to, on one hand, to help these folks see that they actually have more opportunities. And my father joined up again then after Pearl Harbor, and we just went to visit Thomas, the young guy.
Thomas Young.
And, you know, we were talking to him and he said, well, we were living in New York City when September 11th happened and we were moving from New York City to Washington, D.C. And we said, we responded by writing this song. And he said, yeah, I wish I had responded that way. Because if you don't know about Thomas Young, he signed up for the military in response to September 11th and took a bullet to the spinal cord and is now living out his last days at home in Kansas City where we visited him. And I want to get to our sisters and brothers before they make that mistake. I want them to have other options. We were standing at an event and Code Pink came marching in with this great big banner, and we had a little time while they were working out the sound and they were hanging the banner behind us, and we just started singing in the banner. So that's where this song came from. So you can sing the banner with us in this chorus.
Ignorance and arrogance and government for me.
Who died? Who died? Who died?
gun violence. And seems to me that the words are so hollow that not even Congress can get a bill passed, because we still are the biggest weapons manufacturer in the world. And not only that, this drone program, that, you know, even if we were following any kinds of, even if there is such a thing as conventions in war now, there's no possibility, as Medea has so eloquently said, of giving our quote, enemies an opportunity to surrender. There's no possibility of capturing them and taking them captive with these killer drones. And though my father didn't see combat, the problem with training killers is that training comes home with them, regardless of whether they see combat or not. There are more people trained to kill in this country than people who have studied nonviolent communication. And so my nephew followed in my father's footsteps. My nephew's now a Top Gun. And a lifer in the military. So when I read an article in the English version of Der Spiegel online talking about the drone program, and they said that there's a higher incidence of combat fatigue in drone pilots than in conventional fighter pilots, I had to think about my nephew as well as all the people on the ground being affected by his actions. And so this is a brand new song called Killing Game.
and librarians. Both of my parents are librarians. My sister is a librarian. The joke was that I was going to be a music librarian. But this library is an insult to libraries.
Unless somebody right away put these words forward and lifted up the piecework that's being done all around the world, it's just not getting press. It's not not going to appear in the library here. And unless we put these words out there, peace in Arabic, salam, peace in Hebrew, shalom, and peace in English, and then back that up with the work. I mean, I know I'm preaching to the choir.
Amen, sister.
Hey. Amen. Amen.
Because you're doing that work. But we just felt like we need to make the rafters in every single place we go to ring with these words and all the work that goes with it.
Let me just say quickly that the reason we were in Kansas City and that we could meet Thomas Young was because we were invited by a very unexpected group of people who are in this work for peace and justice with us, even though we didn't know. They're a religious denomination that you may not have heard of. You've heard of their originating, their evil twin, the Mormon Church. You've heard of them. But these are folks who were derived from that group, but who ordained women priests, who let everyone
really?
Into their temples, who have just voted in that they will support marriage equality and LGBT rights. And they're called the Community of Christ. And so they brought us in to sing with 4,000 or 5,000 of their good friends to sing this song. So just know that people who you haven't yet met are with us supporting peace and standing up against the lies. So sing with us.
So you know your part. Peace, I love shalom. 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 Peace, I love shalom.
Thank you.